Greetings of the day. On behalf of IHM Kolkata, forwards towards the semester 3 and 4, we are preparing a menu of Indian cuisine. The menu for the day is mutton vindaloo, beans fugat, prawns pulao and dodal. From the name itself, it's very clear the menu has been taken from a vibrant region of India, it's Goa. Goa is a state situated in the west. The culinary history, if I refer back, it has been mixed and matched with the Portuguese colonies, Mughals and the traditional Goan Indian peoples. The food for the day is a mutton preparation along with a rice with a small vegetable accompaniment and a desserts. The mutton preparation is the mutton vindaloo. Now from the name itself, it can be confusing for the students that aloo, whether it has been cooked with aloo or only the mutton. Certainly, aloo is a misconcept. It's not the aloo, it's not mutton vindaloo, it's aloo. Va means wine and aloo is garlic. So it's a combination of garlic and wine. Traditionally, if I go back to the Goanese menu, they used to marinate the mutton for at least 12 hours in wine with the Goan spice. Now here in Goa, the cashew nut and the coconut, the palm are plenty. So they cook, the medium is coconut oil, as their culture says, they always try to finish with the country vinegar, which is known as the fanny vinegar or the toddy wine. To prepare the Goanese food is a must essential. Coconut is plenty over there. In all and every dish you will find a hint of coconut. It can be a varieties of grated coconut. It can be the varieties of coconut milk and whatsoever. As when Goa is a coastal region, the seafood are plenty. Mainly their staple is rice along with fish. The rice what we are going to prepare for the demonstration part is the prawns pulao, which is a combination of the coastal region seafood as well with the rice. Now to start off with the dish, I will start with the dessert first because it requires a setting. Dodal, coconut, rice and the cashew nut. It requires a setting, so I will start with the dodal, then I will proceed towards the other ingredients. Now how to prepare the dodal, let's see to it. The ingredients which require to prepare the dodals are short grain rice has to be soaked in water, then finely powder. We will be requiring the palm jaggery. We will be requiring the 2 pressed coconut milk, first and second. These are the ingredients. Along with it, we will be requiring some broken cashew nut. For the medium of cooking, we will be requiring a hint of ghee. Now how to start with? To start with, we have to sieve the rice flour. As per the recipe, we will be taking the sieved flour. Then has to mix with coconut milk. Now while mixing with the coconut milk, should ensure that there will be no lumps. It's finely mixed. Now we'll be adding the palm jaggery, which gives a very good flavor as well as a dark brown color. Required to mix it well. To mix all the lumps. And now the time to add some more coconut milk to it. The mixing part is over. I will start it with the preparation now. For this, we will be requiring a thick bottom pan, karai. The cooking utensils of Goanese areas, all over, you can say to any Indian cuisine, you require karai to prepare any kind of food, which is mainly with the brush, which has a very thick bottom, and it ensure for sticking of the ingredients. Nice aroma of ghee is coming out. As you all know, ghee has a very less melting point, so you have to add the mixture. We are sieving the mixture, ensure to not to prevent any lumps in the final products. Now I have to cook it from all the sides. In between you have to control the flame, because the things what we are cooking are very high chance of sticking, and if it sticks we will get a very burnt flavor from the products. A little amount of sugar is required, which not only gives the sweetness to the product, which also gives the caramelized color to this dodal. Now the question arises, till how far we have to cook it? It will give you the indication, like when it will be cooked, it will leave all the sides of the container. Now you can see it is starts leaving the sides of the container. I am preparing it a very small amount, so a small portion. It requires 2 to 3 hours of cooking. Now the students, we cannot feel the aroma of the products, but I can explain it. A sweet aroma of coconut milk, jaggery, and the rice are coming out from the dish. Now when it starts leaving the sides of the container, is the time to sprinkle some broken cashew nut. Which not only give you the color difference, as well as it will give you the crunchy effect in your mouth, the texture. Now the preparation of the dodal is done. As you can see, it is coming out as a lump. It's are leaving from the container. So we are making it off the range. Now the second arrangement, what we will be requiring is, we need a tray which should be greased from the back, and it has to be placed on top. Smear it from the top, or else another way is, it can be either kept in a mold. After a few hours it will be set, like suji ka halwa or gajar ka halwa, how this is set, that can also be set. And while we present, it has to cut into pieces. Either it can be cut into square or loci, that is the triangle, or any kinds of fancy decoration can be prepared for it. So I have a stainless steel tray with me. It has to be greased. Now with the help of a knife, once again it has to be greased, ensuring that it will also not stick with the product. See how nicely the product has came. Dark brown in color, contrasting with the cashew nut that we have used, and the product is so beautiful it can be easily sprayed. It just giving you the indication that the product is evenly, properly cooked. If the product was not cooked properly, we cannot spread it. Now the two way it can be kept, either it can be kept in a normal freezer or in ideal room temperature it can be placed in any cool place for at least 2 to 3 hours. It can be then fabricated and it will become ready for serve. Next, students, we are preparing the prawns pulao, once again a famous delicacy of Goa. For this we will be requiring prawns, some spices like bay leaves, cloves, black peppercorn, chopped tomatoes, oil, freshly prepared prawns stock, and basmati rice. Now for the basmati rice we need a pre-preparation. We have to soak the rice, we have to wash it properly, and has to be soaked for at least 35 minutes to 40 minutes. Then it can be used. For this, we can use a common brass dechki with the lid, or we can use a lagan. Now in today's demonstration, I will showing you how to prepare the rice in absorption methods. Now pulao has to be cooked in absorption methods. We cannot cook the pulao in drainage methods. If you cook any kind of nutritious pulao or something like aromatic in drainage method, what will happen? The aroma will be lost while we drain the rice. So first we require a lagan in a moderate heat. Use some refined oil to it. Indian cuisine are very rich, so always refined oil followed with ghee. As you have all seen in your first and second semester, we use refined oil and butter. Now first we will add bay leaves. The whole hot spice, which includes bay leaves, some amount of cloves, and the black peppercorn. Then we will add the fabricated tiger prawns. Till it become bright brown in color, we have to fry it. Ensure in a very soft and gentle hand, otherwise the seafood prawns will break into pieces. Add some fresh diced tomatoes. Add some salt to it. You have all seen that after we add tomatoes, we have to add some salt to extract the extra moisture of the tomatoes. Increase the flame a bit. Now add the rice. It's a long grain basmati rice. Now you have to cook tomato, rice and prawns together. Now the question arises, how far we have to cook it? How long we have to cook it? We have to cook the rice until and unless you get the crackling sounds of the rice. Now let the rice cook till it come to the perfect position, that where you can hear the crackling sounds. Now while preparing the rice, you have already mentioned we can prepare the rice in two methods. One, absorption methods, one, drainage methods. One, there is another method is in between absorption and drainage mix, the way we prepare the biryani. We prepare the rice, then we amalgam the biryani with the mutton or chicken, whatever it is. Then we put it into the methods. I don't know whether we can hear the sound or not. We can easily get the crackling sounds of the rice which are coming out. This is the ideal time to add the stock to it. You have already prepared the stock. Now here the question arises, how much of stock to add it? How much of moisture to add it? Now the thumb rule says, if you are preparing with 500 gram of rice, the stock or moisture should be 1 liter. That is double the amount, 1:2. After adding the stock, you have to add some more ghee to it, clarified butter, which not only give you the perfect aroma of ghee, it also helps, it prevent the sticking of rice, because you know the rice is a starch. If you just heat the starch, it will become gelatinized. So to prevent the gelatinization of starch, we can add some oil or ghee. Now you have to wait till the moisture, cook the rice till it become 1/4 cook. Then we will seal the container from the top and we will put it into the absorption dump methods. Now let the rice cook till it's cooked for 1/4. Now what I am doing, I am starting with the mutton vindaloo. Va is wine, aloe is garlic. Now what are the ingredients required? We require a finely marinated meat. Here is the mutton. We have to marinate with some Goan spice mix, which includes bay leaves, red chili, cinnamon stick, cloves, cumin seeds, coriander seeds, small cardamom, and black mustard seeds. Ideally, what we used to do, we used to soak this mixture in toddy wine vinegar for 11 to 12 hours, and then we make a paste of the mixture. Okay, we'll do the marination later on. Here we can see the rice is 1/4 cooked. The time has came to put it into a dum methods. Once again, we have to smear some ghee from top. And with the help of this aluminium foil, we will cover the lid. Ensure the warm air cannot escape from the container. We are adapting the dum methods here. Cooking is nothing but a combination of science and arts. We all know that the steam has more power than the boiling temperature because it has the latent heat which can be utilized while we cook the rice or mutton in dum methods. The container is almost sealed. There is no question of leaving anything from here. Now I am switching this container to the next range in a very small temperature heads. It can be cooked. It will take 20-25 minutes. Now students, coming back to the mutton, what I said, the spice has to be dipped in toddy vinegar for 12 hours, then it requires a mix. We have seen the spice, what are the spice required, and this is the mixture. This is the mixture we have soaked and grind and kept it for 12 hours. Now the first steps to prepare the mutton vindaloos are, we have to marinate this mutton. Now in your first semester you have already learned what is the significance of marination. Marinades plays a very important role in Indian cuisine. Now mutton is a red meat which require more time to cook, but if we use the proper marination, it can reduce the cooking time as well as the cooking temperature. Now first, the salt and ginger garlic. Now why we are adding salt to it? Obviously for seasoning. But salt has another role. When you will apply salt to any of the meat, due of osmosis procedure, all the moisture which are there in the meat will comes out. Then whatever the marination you will add, it will mix with the mutton, and after certain time, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, the osmosis procedure will stop, and due of the gravitational force, the moisture settles down to the meat once again. And when the moisture is settling down, it carries all the aroma, flavor what you have used in the marination, and that is the reason being it tender the meat very quickly. So my mutton is marinated. Now once again we will be requiring a heavy bottom, because to cook the Indian food in high temperature we require always a heavy bottom pan. Allows the container to absorb some heat, and that is the reason being we are using the brass or copper, which facilitate to prevent the heat, to retain the heat rather, for a longer period of time. We'll add the refined oil. Some heat to it and tempering it with whole hot spices. Now in different region of India the term tempering are differ. Like in West Bengal we call it foron, bagar, chok, pondio. There are many terms but the thing are the same. Now we'll add the onions, nicely sliced onions. Now when you are cooking the onions, as you all know, onion is an aqueous vegetables, so we require some salt. The salt will extract the moisture and it will helps to cook the onion very fast. Now let it come to golden brown in color, and in between give a twist. The reason being the air inside will pass from bottom to top, and as because it is sealed from the top, it will moves from top to bottom once again in the convection process. Now my onions are golden brown in color. I'll be adding the chopped tomatoes to it. Now I'm adding the aloe, vindaloe, aloe, garlic. And we have seen that Indian food cannot complete without the ginger. Now what is ginger garlic? Is only a spice? No, it's not only a spice. It has multiple functions. It helps to give a body to the products, give a base to the products. It helps to tenderize the meat as a tenderizer. It helps to increase the key value of the food. We can retain the products for a longer period of time if it has been mixed with ginger and garlic paste. My masala is getting cooked, and it's a common tendency of ginger, as because it's very fibrous in nature, it will stick to the container. So in between, we can give a splash of moisture. Now you can just recollect with your first and second semester deglazing with wine. That means whatever the splatter are there in the side of the container, it will settle down. Here we are deglazing the things with moisture. It will take some time to make it golden brown in color. So I can switch over to my last products, that is beans fugat. So in the range rice is on, mutton vindaloo is on. I'm starting with beans fugat. Now beans fugat is another delicacy, the vegetable preparation. For this we'll be requiring cumin seeds, mustard seeds, curry leaves, chopped onion, French beans and grated coconut. Now I'm shifting the mutton from this range to this. It will take some time. First, some refined oil. Tempering it with mustard seeds. A hint of chopped onion. Fabricated French beans which are already parboiled. A mixture of cumin and green chilies. Some salt. In second semester, first semester, always salt and pepper, but in Indian cuisine is very funny, is salt and rock salt. Salt for the seasoning and rock salt is not the salt, is a spice in Indian cuisine. So give a good mix to the spice. Then we will add the grated coconut. Now Goan people are crazy with coconut. When you are in Goa, be like the Goans. Cannot complete that day with fenny. Finally, a tempering. Or tarka or bagar, or in Bengal we call it foron. Tempering it with a black mustard, a very little because you have already added black mustard there, and hand pricked fresh herbs, that is curry leaves. Now there is two way of adding tempering. One, you can add the product in this, or else we can add the tempering on the products. We'll add the product in the mixture of tempering, and it's yummy. I can get the aroma of coconut, mustards and the fresh herbs, curry leaves. Now the first product, what is complete, is beans fugat. Now in between we have prepared the beans fugat. Now we can see the onions are completely golden brown in color and melt with tomatoes, and the consistency what has came is completely a gravy consistency. Now this is the time to add the marinated mutton to it. have already explained, if the mutton is marinated nicely, it can be cooked very easily. I will add some moisture to it. Now finally I will add the Goan spice mix with vinegar and some toddy vinegar from top. The color is already achieved, bright reddish brown in color, and yes, the perfect blend of aloe, garlic with the vinegar. For the timing, simmer it and wait till the mutton is full tender. Now students, coming back to the rice, I believe it is already cooked. Let open the lid, it's not lid, the aluminium foil, to check the rice. Now be very careful. If you burn by boiling water and if you burn by the steam, burning of steam is much more painful. Now check the rice. It's perfectly done. Now how to check the doneness of the rice? If you see closely, you will find the uppermost layer is upright straight, which gives the indication rice has become completely cooked, fluffy and soft. Now we can check there is no moisture inside. All are nicely blended. A nice aroma of prawns are coming from the rice, which is now ready for serve. Now I'm placing the rice here. Back with the lid. And in between, the mutton is absolutely done. The bones are coming out from the muttons, which give us the indication the mutton is absolutely cooked. Now students, the time for presentation. Now students, we have completed the Goan menu. We have prepared prawns pulao, mutton vindaloo, beans fugat and dodol. So you have seen how to prepare the rice in absorption methods with some spice, herbs and prawns. You have seen the mutton vindaloo, vah, aloe with Indian herbs and spice. Beans fugat, one of the delicacy of Goan vegetables with dodol. I believe you have seen the things how to prepare it, and you can give it a try obviously in your house by collecting all the ingredients, referring these videos in your hand. Thank you so much.